We're going to look at the Mozambique Spitting Cobra now. So for that, I am going to just put on safety glasses. You will see a Mozambique Spitting Cobra. Right, it's just spat on my right hand here. And that spitting was without making a hood. These snakes are able to spit venom without making a hood. If you think you're going to wait for the snake to make a hood, there we can see the snake spraying the venom, and again, okay, very effective defense strategy. Right. I'm just going to get a bit more control over the snake's body. Okay, so without making a hood, these snakes can spray the venom. They can make a hood, they make a very nice, broad, very impressive hood when they do hood. They don't often keep that hooded position for very long. It's a short duration hood, spray the venom, and off they go again. These snakes are normally light or dark brown, as you see here. The interstitial skin, the skin between the scales, is black, so you get this net effect on the snake's body. The underside is normally light pink or yellow. Sometimes apricot. This particular specimen has quite a dark underside, right? And then it's got a number of dark bands on the neck region, as you can see there. The venom is mainly cytotoxin. There is a neurotoxic component. That neurotoxic component is dangerous to small children and dogs, as it can kill both small children and dogs. The normal effect from a spitting cobra bite, that cytotoxic venom will attack the tissue. Right, the fangs are fairly short, so the tissue that gets attacked is the skin and subcutaneous fatty layer, causing a painful aggressive swelling syndrome. Swelling is not as severe as a puffer bite. Swelling is also slower in its effect. The puffer bites can produce swelling of 10 to 15 centimeters per hour. And as a big spitting cobra, swelling is normally at a rate of 1 to 2 centimeters per hour. These snakes are found in typical bushveld habitat. We find them from the southern part of KwaZulu-Natal, up the KwaZulu-Natal coast, into Zululand through Mozambique, and then westwards through the provinces of Mpumalanga, northern Gauteng, and northwest, Limpopo province, eastern parts of Botswana, through Zimbabwe into Zambia. They also occur in northern Namibia. Right. So that's your Mozambique Spitting Cobra, a snake of about 1.2 to 1.5 meters in length normally. They can grow up to 1.8 meters in length. And they eat virtually everything they can find. Warm-blooded prey, cold-blooded prey. Cold-blooded prey will even consist of snakes. If they find snakes, they'll eat them. Once again, they are very partial to eating puffetas.
Thanks for watching this video clip. My name is Mike Perry from African Reptiles and Venom.